You know, there are some people dedicated to public service. I have one of those persons with me today, Alderwoman Sharon Pace, today on The Bernie Hayes Show. Welcome back. Sharon, it's been a long time. You should have been here many, many times before now.
Yeah, and it's a pleasure for me to be here now, and I certainly appreciate your invite.
Welcome. You're Alderwoman now.
Well, I will be. I'm running for the Alderperson for April the 7th election, and that's for Ward 1 in Northwoods.
Okay, your tenure as a state rep?
Yes, I have been a state rep, and I was an Alderwoman before, prior to that, in the same position.
Okay, in what, Northwoods?
Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So before I actually ran for the state house, you know, I was an Alderperson, and I had to resign that seat
back in
2008.
Yeah, because of term limits.
Yeah. Well, I resigned the aldermatic seat because I was going to the house. But the term limit, yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
Term
exactly, in the house.
State rep, because... Mm-hmm. More people cry when he says, "Oh my goodness, Sharon Pace is going to have Sharon Pace."
Oh
my goodness!
But, I cry too.
So you're going back to the automatic seat, Ward 1.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what does that include? What are the boundaries of Ward 1 and Northwoods?
Well, Ward 1 surrounds Lucas and Hunt, Highway 70, and on the south is Natural Bridge, and it goes down to Pasadena.
Okay.
Okay, and Nelson.
Okay, that's a big ward.
It's a pretty big ward.
And a lot of well traveled too.
Yes, very much so.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
Tell me why you dedicated your life to public service, because you could have done anything that you wanted to do, but yet still you've been a public servant for a long time.
Yes, I think it started. You know, I've been a director of patient accounts for, I don't want to date myself, but like 30 something years, and it's about helping people. And I've always believed in giving back. And we know people need help. Even in the hospital, I was a patient account advocate. And people just have such a hard time, you know, with their health. Well, health insurance now, period. Mm-hmm. But with the health situation that's going on, we certainly want to make sure that we expand Medicaid. And there is a petition that's going around now. So I'm certainly in the support of that, and we've been working trying to get those signatures so we can get that on the ballot again. And hopefully this time they will listen to the people, even though they're trying to reverse the decision that the people made about Clean Missouri.
Now, when is the election?
The election is April 7th.
April 7th, okay.
Yes.
So we have, is it still time to register to vote?
Yes. Yes, you can register for that one. And I just wanted to mention, too, about the presidential election coming up, too.
Yeah, sure.
March the 10th, and I don't know if some people may want to be a delegate, but you have to vote in that particular election.
Right.
Otherwise, you cannot qualify to be a delegate in your area.
Yeah, those two dates kind of confuse people, March and April.
Mm-hmm.
But March is for the presidential and then the national.
Yes.
And locally.
The general.
April,
The general.
You also... so active in the community, you know.
Yes.
In fact, every civic and progressive event that I go to, there's Sharon Pace.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Why do you support them?
Well, I support them because you have to get out and you have to talk to the people. You have to be a part of it. You can't just show up because it's election time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you have to be visible. And I just love meeting and talking to people and finding out what they really want, you know, what your needs are, and then try to help along those lines or get the resources to try to help and contact other people, you know, that can help them.
Yeah. A lot of times I'll be talking to you and they're talking to people about you, and then they always bring up your faith and say, she's such a faithful person, and she loves her God. Tell us about your faith.
Yes. Well, I'm a Baptist, you know, and I attend First Baptist Church at the city of St. Louis. It's the oldest church west of the Mississippi, about 200 years old, and our pastor is Reverend Harvey Midget and First Lady Jackie Midget. And I've been there since I was a little tot coming up with my aunt and my grandmother, all of that, you know. So it's a family church. My sister has since moved, but that's still her home church.
Sure.
But she goes to the Chesterfield Church, but she's still a Baptist in Chesterfield with Dr. Stubblefield. But you know, it's just been, I've been, you know, it's a church that it's family, and we've been there, and, you know, I just continue to go back there. Mm-hmm. And I visit others, too. Tommy Pearson's church is great,
yeah.
You know, so sure. Reverend Pearson, and so visit his church.
Glenn Echo.
Greater St. Mark's,
Glenn Echo.
Glenn.
A couple things I want to talk to you about. The election itself. Now, how can they reach you, and how can they support you, and what are the priorities now for Northwoods?
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, they can reach me at either Sharon.Pace@att.net, which is my email.
Email, okay.
And then the phone number is 314-383-2390.
Okay.
And some of the challenges we're having, I will say, in Northwoods is I think everyone that knows us or in that area knows that the North Oaks Plaza is our main revenue.
Right.
And that's with Greg Sansone. And he's doing great things building that particular area up or that that plaza. Because we do have NAACP is in that area now, as well as the Father Support Group.
The county NAACP is there?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, the county has office up there as well. Mm-hmm. And then we have CASA, Community Action right. Agency of St. Louis County.
Sure.
We also have a hub for our, I think they're the special unit for the police department in the county. Wow. If you remember, Stinger moved them out to, well, the county out of that building, period.
Sure.
And we were paying rent.
I remember
paying. So they're back there currently. And hopefully they'll stay there because it's a good, you know, safety net and security for the
community. That's off Natural Bridge, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Right there off of Natural Bridge.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. So that plaza is really building up. We're going to have a clinic there that's coming. We have a big dialysis center there as well.
Yeah.
So they're doing great things.
I know you campaign even when you were running for state rep on health care.
Mm-hmm.
And how's your feeling on health care now? What's the need?
The need is to sign that petition.
Yeah.
We need to make sure we try to expand it again.
Mm-hmm.
I think the need has gotten worse, if anything. I'm sure it has. They're taking hundreds of thousands of kids off of Medicaid, and they're claiming it as a victory. You know, we have this money. But we do know that they're cutting a lot of the social programs due to the fact that the money, they're trying to make up the differences and the deficit and the cuts that they had given to the rich.
Mm-hmm.
So I voted against that bill when I was in Jefferson City as well.
Mm-hmm.
And we know that our kids and our seniors also, as well as our youth, need our health care.
Mm-hmm. Although you are running again for the seat in Northwoods, but I also know that you're very much friends to most people of this in the city, and that you're great support of Kim Gardner.
Oh, yes, definitely. Yeah. Kim, in fact, I thanked Kim, and I'll thank her again. She came and she spoke at the National Women's Political Caucus, which we gave a training session for individuals that are actually running for office.
Mm-hmm.
And I do support Kim. I think she's doing a fantastic job, as well as when she served in the House. She was in Jefferson City with me during that tenure, and you know, she's a wonderful person, and she believes in people, and she's definitely trying to reform in a way that it affects everybody. So it's a whole, you know, it's for a whole group of people, not just one segment.
Sure.
And I just think that, you know, we need to get behind her and keep her in my prayers all the time, and I tell her that.
That's great.
Mm-hmm.
I guess it's Sharon Pace. She's running for her old seat in Northwoods as the first ward alderwoman, and she's done a wonderful job then, and she's going to do another job after she's reelected. And we're here at the New Life Evangelistic Center, 2428 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri. And Reverend Larry Rice has been trying to reopen 1411 Locust Street along with his volunteers and help and support. We need your help and support. But the same services that were provided down there are provided here at 2428 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri. Some of the needs of the New Life Evangelistic Center, if you can bring them by, hats and gloves and scarves, hygiene products like shampoo, conditioning, soap, and body wash, laundry detergent, washcloths and towels, body and face lotions, things of that sort. And 2428 Woodson Road, Overland, Missouri. And you may help us through a tax-deductible donation at Post Office Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166, or online at newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. American Express, Visa, Discover Card. All it takes less than 2 minutes to make a contribution, a well-needed contribution, tax-deductible contribution to New Life Evangelistic Center. We'll be back with Sharon Pace after this.
It's cold outside, and the homeless urgently need gloves. Like the man I met this morning on the corner, who only had socks over his hands. I didn't have any gloves to give him. And I think of Leah, who came into our building years ago. His fingers had frozen to the extent that he went into the restroom and washed his hands, and the fingers literally broke off in the sink. That can happen. It does happen. So many are losing the tips of their fingers because they don't have gloves. Please bring your gloves to 2428 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri. Or you can bring them to 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, Missouri. It's critical that we receive gloves at this time. Please have a glove drive at your church, at your business. I thank God for those who are bringing coats, but now it's gloves that urgently need. Or send your much-needed financial gift to the New Life Evangelistic Center at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. You can give online at nlecstl.org. Please share. Please care so we can get the gloves.
Welcome back. My guest is the candidate for the first ward alderperson in the city of Northwoods. She's a former alderwoman in the first ward in Northwoods, Missouri, also, and former state representative, and widely known, widely respected, widely loved, Sharon Pace. Sharon, you do so much, and we talked about your faith, and we talked about the positions you've held. What drives you?
I think I'm motivated. It's a passion that you have within, and it comes from the heart. We certainly know it's not about the money, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, so, but the people and just the need, you know, and it seems like it's getting worse, you know. In fact, it is, and just trying to help. It's a matter of helping individuals and giving of yourself, and I've always believed in that. And so wherever I can help, then I will be there.
Mm-hmm. I know also that you, Hazel Irby, well, all the people in St. Louis County Council, you know them. Mm-hmm. Do you work with them?
Yes, I do. I work with Hazel as well as Waretta, Greta Days, and she was a guest speaker too with one of our events. Mm-hmm. They're great. You know, I haven't had, I think we're in the same place, you know, as far as trying to get to know what we can do to move the city and the county, the region really forward. Mm-hmm. So we're open. And we learn to, if we have a disagree, we learn to disagree, we agree to disagree,
you know,
but you don't lose friendship and the communication that you need in order to move everything forward.
Have you been the victim of gender discrimination?
Yes.
Tell us about it, if you don't mind.
Well,
you know, is it still there?
Yes, it is. Yeah. It is. Mm-hmm. I think it's just coming out more so, you know, it's more prevalent now. You know, even in the house, you know, I think it's everywhere.
Yeah,
so, I've had several instances, I guess I can mention one. Well, even in the house, you know, where individuals are, I'll say, some of the legislators or what have you, they have a tendency to have meetings and they neglect the females. And when we talk about our health care as well. either if you're pro-choice, pro-life, or whatever. We're not at the table in those discussions.
About you.
Yes, about us and our bodies and, yeah. And what we should do, you know. So that in itself says, you know, it leads you to think that you're not important, mm-hmm. and it's about you. So why should we not be there? Sure. But when you walk in a room and all the discussion is about you, and you're not there, then that's a definite problem. Mm-hmm. I've been told that I need in some meetings, and one in particular when I was elected, that I need to just be quiet and not ask questions.
And, that blatant.
Yes, that blatant. Yes, and you just got here, and you need to just learn what's going on, and I said a few words, and said that's not going to work, because I do ask questions.
They don't know Sharon Pace.
They don't know me. Okay, and that's about the budget. So, of course, we lost friendship, or if you want to call it that, or whatever, you know, it didn't work out for a while. But now they came around, and they know me, and they know I'm going to ask questions, and I need answers, you know. So we're okay now. But that was initially when I first started out, I had that to happen to me, just to be quiet and listen. You're here to listen. You don't know what you're doing yet, so you're not to ask any questions.
That's unbelievable. That's unbelievable.
Yes.
In healthcare itself, we mentioned that a couple of times earlier. Mm-hmm. What are the primary goals I guess initiatives that you'd like to see changing in healthcare?
Well, I'd like to see more people really sit down at the table and come up with some solutions as to what needs to be done. You know, we have, like the women issues, we have male issues as well.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
But I think everything seems to revolve around women's issues these days, or their concerns and their health care versus anything else. And as I stated, you're not a part of the conversation. So you have the groups. We have National Women's Political Caucus that's mm-hmm. there, and they're pro-choice, which I am the vice president of.
Okay.
Okay. And, you know, so we're pushing those, the narrative, you know, that you have a right to your choice. And we're not saying we're pro-abortion. Mm-hmm. We're saying, but you have a right to choose. It's between you, your doctor, and upstairs.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
And it's simple as that. And so when you don't, and this is America, supposedly, mm-hmm. so you should have a right to make your decisions and have your own opinions as well.
You have need for volunteers for your candidacy and donations and so forth?
Definitely, always, in the latter part especially, but volunteers, definitely.
Tell us how we can reach you.
Yes, you can certainly reach me at 314-383-2390.
A lot of folks can't write that fast.
Okay, let me slow down a little bit. Okay, I can do that. Area code 314-383-2390. That's great. And then you can send the donation to 4417 O'Neill, that's O-N-E-I-L-L Avenue, St. Louis, Missouri, 63121. That's Committee to Elect Sharon Pace.
Okay, I didn't know that was there. Well, mm-hmm. that should have been on the screen. Mm-hmm. And I'm not sure Bob will put it up for us.
Oh.
The email?
The email is sharon.pace@att.net.
I know that's your network also with the people in the city. What do you think about the city-county merger?
I'm not for it. Mm-hmm. I'll just be point blank. I think some services can be merged at this time. I think they need to have an in-depth review of the city finances as well, because, you know, you take on the responsibility of another the county, city, or whichever way it goes, or vice versa, their budget, and to see what the deficits are, what you're actually going to be inheriting and adopting, because we don't really know. We don't know all the intricacies of that. And that makes me kind of leery, especially when you're going to start rushing the situation and not letting the people be involved. That's really should be the city and the county, and you spread it to other areas. And I don't think that was the right way to do that, to cut out the people that are actually it's going to touch and affect.
Okay. Now, again, tell us when the deadline for registrations are.
Okay. The registration deadline, they're sending out, now for which one? Because they're sending. Okay, because see, and I need to look. I didn't bring that with me.
That's okay.
Yeah, but they're sending out, I know absentee ballots are coming out now for the presidential election.
Right, okay.
Okay,
But for your election, it's when?
Yeah, I think it's March the 12th, if I'm not mistaken.
But it's that second or third week in March.
Yes.
Yeah, and the election is April.
Mm-hmm, in April. But you can certainly go to the election board website and get the exact date.
Douglas County Election Board. Okay, that's great.
Douglas County.
There's so much I want to talk to you about. Anything you want to talk about that I haven't asked you about? Let's do it in the next segment because we have another segment to do.
Okay.
But in the meantime, I want to just talk about your activism when we come back also and the things that you want to talk about.
Okay.
And I want everybody to notice the mugs on the table here.
Mm-hmm.
And this is Harris Stowe State University mug.
Yes.
That's the Webster University mug where I teach also. This is the Bernie Hayes Show mug. And this is a mug that the judge and Justice Draper gave me. Mm-hmm. And when they went to the inaugural, that you also have a beautiful purse.
Mm-hmm.
This is representing that.
Nice cup.
But this cup right here, Reverend Rice, wants everyone to have. And it will not only help me, but not only help Reverend Rice, but it'll help everyone who's connected with New Life Evangelism Center. So let's listen to Reverend Larry Rice tell you about how you can get a Bernie Hayes Show mug.
The Bernie Hayes program is produced at NLEC TV right here at 2428 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri. It's our new headquarters since they closed the 1411 Locust building. We're working to get back into that building. In addition to that, trying to help so many people through a wide variety of safe houses, training programs, transportation assistance, so many ways people are getting help because of all of you that are supporting the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. Now, if you'll send a gift of $25 or more, we want to send you this special, the Bernie Hayes Show Cup. And we're giving that to people as just a way of saying thank you. So when you send your gift, request a cup. We'll be happy to get it off to you. It's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. You can give online at nlecstl.org. Now I'm really asking all of you to join us in praying. The needs are so phenomenal at this particular time. So many hurting and homeless people are contacting us daily, but we're able to help them because of each one of you that are praying, caring, and sharing at this time. Tell your family, certain friends about NLEC TV and get directly involved yourself.
We'll return, our guests, after this Black History Moment. Today's subject, Nina Mae McKinney. Described as Hollywood's first Black movie star, and yet her name is often missing from histories and encyclopedias. Nina Mae McKinney was born in 1912 in a small town of Lancaster, South Carolina. By the age of 16, she landed a role in the chorus line of Lou Leslie's Blackbirds, starring Will Robinson. Spotted by director King Vidor in 1929, he cast her as a bad girl, Chick, in the film Hallelujah, the first Black all-musical feature film. At only 17 at the time, the strength of her performance netted her a 5-year contract with MGM. Young and beautiful, she was a leading lady in an industry that had no leading roles for Black women, and she fell into a round of minor support roles, such as the vamp or domestic in the films. After the outbreak of World War II, she returned to New York, where she married jazz musician Jimmy Moore, and when she succumbed to a heart attack at the age of 54, her death went unnoticed in the entertainment industry and by the media. Nina Mae McKinney.
NLEC TV will continue to bring you wholesome family programming, plus many, many community shows that you only can see on NLEC TV. It's very important you bring it up on your iPhone, the NLEC TV app, or continue to watch it on 24.2. You'll be able to continue to see the Bernie Hayes Show, Zaki Baruti. You'll be able to see Transformation Church with Pastor Burris. In addition to that, you'll be able to see our Here's Help programs and news and views and so much more new and creative stuff that's going to be brought to you on NLEC TV. If you have questions on how to get that app on your iPhone or how to tune in 24.2, call now 314-436-2424. It's NLEC TV that's going to continue to bring you the best in wholesome community, family, entertainment, and renewable energy programming. So be sure you stay right there on NLEC TV. For further information, call 436-2424.
And welcome back. My guest is Mrs. Sharon L. Pace. She's the candidate for the first ward alderperson in Northwoods, Missouri. And Ms. Pace, when we left, you were going to tell us what you want to talk about. Some things that you think important.
I think it's very important that we vote.
Okay.
I think that's the main thing. And we have so many people. I know the state of mind of where we are as a country. that people are really discouraged with number 45 and what's going on. And I feel that we've had individuals that have fought for us to vote, and we don't need, the oppression is there, but we need to still fight and make sure that our voice counts. And that's the only way to do that.
There's still some voter suppression efforts in play, right?
Exactly, okay, definitely. And it's so many, I've talked to college kids, or I won't say kids, but college individuals. Or
yeah,
people,
young adults.
The students, sure. The young adults, mm-hmm. Yeah. And I guess some of them may get offended by that, but, you know, to me, as old as I am, everybody's a kid.
Millennials.
Yeah, millennials and exes, you know, all of that, yeah. And that's fine. But we have good communication. You know, my daughters are in those ranges, too, so sure. We have good communication. But some of them, even when I was a delegate, you know, to the last presidential election and went to Pennsylvania, you know, I talked to one on the trolley or what have you, and he just said he wasn't going to vote, and if he did, he was talking about voting, you know, for Trump.
Wow.
Okay, and I said, well, it's not going to get any better. So we had a conversation, but, you know how many more like that just feel that it's hopeless.
Sure.
You know,
yeah.
And you try to reach out and you say, you know, things are going to change, but it can't change if you don't vote either. You have to have people in office that have a mindset that you have and that care about what you care about, your needs, and, you know, and it's not all about being socialist, but that's what they seem to want to label it, but it's about caring about people.
Right.
Okay? And it's about you being able to do something about it and making sure that your voice makes a difference, because it does.
Let's get back to helping Sharon L. Pace.
Okay.
How can we help you, and how can we contact you?
Well, you can certainly help me, and I certainly would appreciate it. You can contact me at Sharon.Pace@att.net, which is my email address. Mm-hmm. Also, you can make donations to Committee to Elect Sharon Pace at 4417 O'Neill Avenue at St. Louis, Missouri, 63121. And
that
I certainly
number?
Would appreciate it.
Is there a phone number they can reach you?
And the phone number is area code 314-383-2390.
It's one thing I always notice about you, even during all the years you were state rep, and even when you were older person before you became a state rep, you were always accessible. But I always call your number, you would answer.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I assume that still happens with your constituents?
That happens now, and I get calls from constituents as we speak today,
You
know, around the clock, even though there are other people representing them.
Sure.
And sometimes, like you said, they can't get through to them or they don't get a call back. You will get a call back.
Yeah.
Okay. I won't call you at 3 in the morning, although the mayor calls me at 3 in the morning. But and say, well, we got to talk about this, and that's fine, you know, but I will call you.
Okay.
And that has not been a problem. I understand. I've always sent birthday cards to my seniors. You know, I think that's something that shows, you know, I appreciate them, and they're deserving. And a lot of people don't have families at a certain age, so my seniors certainly do that. I do that for them. Also, I'm a coordinator of the food bank that's in Northwoods now for our seniors.
Wow.
And so 60 and over, and according to the income guidelines, of course, all that makes a difference,
sure,
that we sign those individuals up. They have that. We have a club called the Oaks, and the Oaks is, stands for older adult kids.
Right.
Okay, so I'm a member of that as well. And we have programs for our children. We have the Redbird Rookies that Mary Avery is involved with. And,
I just want to say thank you so much. You do so much. And I just sincerely hope that people use the power to vote to reelect you to the first ward, Northwoods, because you've done so much. You've done so much for public service. You've done so much for the country and so much for us. And so much to support me all the years, too. I've got to tell people how much Sharon Pace has supported me. And I just want to say thank you so much for being here. And thank each and every one of you for the support you've given me and the New Life Evangelist Center. And I sincerely hope that you continue to do so. And I will do my best to continue to support you. I'm Bernie Hayes. Have a great day. Until next time.